Hello everybody and welcome to SitGet 007 Gaming Studio. So now I'm actually having uploaded a video for a while to my YouTube channel, so I think I might start off with something new, like Subnautica. And well, as you can guess, I'm on the Floater Islands. It's a very big area and it's very exciting once you get used to this place here. And also, I built a base right here. So it's pretty cool though. And I have my own garden right outside the base, and you can actually see my Cyclops underneath the water. And it's pretty much cool. Yes, I would love to have something to eat. And also, what I just did was the hidden the bubble tree with my knife, so I can actually eat the bubble tree sample, which gives me a lot of water. Oh wait, this wasn't what I intended to do, but it's pretty cool though. Oh, we claim water. Well, it's because I have a suit which makes me, as you can see, a steel suit which reclaims the moisture from the body, which kinda sounds gross, but that's how it's the game probably works. But that's the first entrance to my base from the islands, and I plan to make an observatory because it's really a nice view from here though. And also you can see the tip of my Cyclops right beneath it. Oh. Well, I just thought I saw my antenna move, but it's probably just me. And then, the base underneath, I actually have my moon pool. It's kinda difficult to find it, but after some time and researching on the internet, I figured out how to find those moon pool fragments. And now, I have my CMOD stuck inside. You can actually see it blinking right out. And so, my base underneath, really nice place though. And also, most of these game like Subnautica, I watched Jacksepticeye play it and Markiplier too. So most of the information actually came from these two guys, so hopefully they actually have been a big help to me for this game. Yeah, that's the Cyclops. I named my Cyclops an underwater vehicle. Sorry, I can't speak it. But I named those something with which ends on diver. Like my Seymour is named Silly Diver because it's really agile and move easily around in the water, but the Cyclops is called Fearless Diver because nothing can scare it away. Oh, and there was actually a thing I need to make because there's some area I haven't searched for yet, so Terraformer. That's actually the thing I haven't built yet, so I have to make one. And I always made the propulsion cannon. It's actually in my Cyclops, which is pretty cool. And I have some plans for my base. The first thing is that, yeah, I have a floodlight right here, and it just light the base and the area right here. Is really cool though. Also, I wonder why the hell did I need these torpedoes for? I don't actually know how to put them into my CMOD. So, if any of you know how to do it, please tell me. And that's inside my Cyclops, where I plan to do the pot and I got the hanging food. So whenever I feel hungry or thirsty, just pick a few of them and eat them. You'll never feel hungry anymore or thirsty. thirsty. Yeah, the propulsion cannon and stuff. Yeah, and I have a lot of power cells because I don't like to run out of power when I sail around in my cyclop. So that's why, if you can see, there's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of them right now, and my power level is at 411. So that might be cool. And also, this locker is only for producing those power cells and batteries as well, because the power cells need to be built by 2 parts of battery and 1 silicone rubber. So that's why. And then I have these 4 random lockers with titanium, lithium, magnesium, computer chip, quartz, and stalker tool, enamel glass and stuff. So many things, and this is only for rare material. Well, gold isn't really that rare, but whatever. And this is empty. But I have upgraded my cyclop a bit. I think where it can reach the depth of 500 meter, which I think is what Markiplier is trying to do in his next video. So yeah, let me see, I need a Vance Viren kit. How do I do that? Well, it's been a while since I played this game because I can't remember it actually. Terraformer, and battery as well. Alright, so advanced mine. Okay, I need 2 part gold and 1 part computer chip. So that do I have here, and 2 part of the golden. So then we have this. And what the other thing I need? Oh, battery. I have one here. And now we are ready. Also, I think when nothing is really happening, I'm going to edit most of that out, because it's not really exciting to watch somebody riding the cyclop just to get out and search some area. And I really need a sea glider as well, but since in the new upgrade to this version of Subnautica, I can't really find any precise information about that. Yeah, I have a really large aquarium here, so whatever. Deep mushrooms. I think I take my sea mod with me. Also, I think I need to sane it as well. My upgrades modification, because yeah, I think the whole reinforcement is quite unnecessary, and so as the storage module, if I just can store everything in my C-mod so far. But first I need to use some titanium, because I want the C-mod to I want the cyclop to be docked a quite lower place, so I need to rebuild this entire thing. So I'm sorry, I'm going to edit most of this out, so we'll see you at the other side. Okay, so now I actually built something right beneath me, and you guys are going to see it very soon. So hold on to your horses. Oh wait, what? No. God damn it, I completely forgot. Now I moved my parking dock a bit lower this time. Maybe I shouldn't park it that low, but so here we go. And now we're going to see it. suit really well right here. Also, I'm planning on like surrounding my cyclop here with a lot of corridors and making sure that I just easily can just drop out of my cyclop and go into my base and get into my vertical connectors and stuff. So that's what my plan is for now. Maybe I need to move this foundation. Come on, deconstruct already. Oh, a chest component must be deconstructed first. God damn it. Alright, so that's what I do for now with my base. Now we have to go and explore to the area. And this might be a little bit tricky because this is actually going to take some while. I hope we're going to see the Reaper Leviathan. Wait, it was Leviathan Reaper. I'm not sure, I'm messing up the most of the thing, so you have to correct me if I'm wrong. God damn it, I can't even English good. But here we go, in our silly diver, toward our cyclop. Fearless diver. Oh. Well, that wasn't real. Oh my god, I'm pushing it up. Ooh. Well, that was fun. So, now it's resharding, and it's already resharded for my moon pool, so it doesn't necessarily have to be a problem by now. So, every time when I'm going to travel with my cyclop, I close every single door in this one. So now, heat signature. Oh, I think I might have been here before. I think about in the heat signature areas, I found my moon pool fragment. I'm not sure. It might be. But for now, let's travel. Wait a second. Weaver don't usually used to be this close to the surface. I'm sorry, I'm mixing up my things. Sorry. It's the Weaver we're seeing right here, and it's extremely close to the water. And I'm not in creative mode or something, but this is really new to me to see them so close to the surface. So, move on, shall we? Okay, I'm probably going to edit this in, but did you guys actually hear a Reaper? Oh my god, it's really freaking me out. The most thing I hate about this game is that you actually can hear the monsters but not see them. And that's quite disappointing for me. Oh, there it is. Should we follow it? Come on, guy. I know you want to see it really up close. Just watch it. Do you see it? Wait. Where did it go? Where did the Weaver go? I'm not sure, but something is really glitching out here. Hopefully developers see this and fix it soon. Oh, so many fragments here. It's so creepy. I don't like it. So, Why I'm actually watching these fragments is because I want the modification station and a sea glider. But I can't really find it anywhere. I'm trying to search it on the internet, but it doesn't seem to be correct information they show. So I have to try it up. And yeah, I know it only gets titanium now when it, since I already got the C mod and other stuff. Yeah, I don't even bother scanning you. So, oh, come on. I know it's right beside a gigantic ship, and it's mostly, yeah, you know, ship fragments and stuff. No, there's nothing here. I've been collecting a lot of stuff since I edited this out, so bear over with me, because I want to expand my territory at the base. So, and also later we are going to see my first base I ever built. So, see you at the other side. So here we are. Oh, I maybe shouldn't drive any further with my cyclop, because this isn't good to sail on low water. So let's park it here for now. And also, I got an exterior roadmap, and I want to make these creepvine cluster. So, I'm sure I have everything in order. And those ice plants make sure that I have light around me. So that's pretty useful if you suddenly got lost and you can in the far distance see light, and then you like, oh, there where I have to go. And also another floodlight in here. But let's see how the first base actually is from the inside. There are maybe a few windows and one simple locker and a wall locker named Silly after my C-mod. And wait a minute, was that here all the time? Oh wait, the battery could be useful, but I'm not sure about the flare thingy. Because I know the flare gave me light when I beneath the surface, and I can't see anything, so then I just light one. Oh, I have to open this. So often. And my inside garden. Pretty cool though. Yeah, but I'm not using this place as much as I'm supposed to, but still, it's better than nothing. So, yeah. And a small aquarium. Pretty awesome. I'm not sure you can put the plants inside these, but it would be pretty cool if you could. Oh! Nothing. Locker, nothing here. And nothing here. So, I don't need another medical kit. So, that's how my first base actually looked like. And my escape pod is not so far from here. I can take my C-mod and go to that place, but it's required that I have to raise my cyclop a little bit so it doesn't just bump into the ground and suddenly glitch like stuff. So, let me show you guys. So, here we go. Down in the water. And now we can go. I really love the Seamoss. You travel so much faster underwater. And yeah, here is my escape pod. pretty awesome though. Let me see, do I... Yeah, I have it. So... Well... Whoa! That was new. I mean, they actually say they fixed the thing that when you fix the escape pod, it will suddenly stop firing and lightning and stuff, but... I never really thought it would be that much lighter in here. So much happiness. Medical kit fabricator. Nah, not going to do that. And mercy much as well. So, I'm going to cut out of the game because I'm going back to my base and building more stuff. And also, oh, I have to show, my mobile vehicle bay is right here. I have to admit that I haven't used it that much, because it's only these two things I can build so far, the C-Mod and the Cyclop. Once you got the Cyclop, you have everything. Like a transporter, storage, and stuff like that. So, you don't need the mobile vehicle bay for more than that. And when you have the sea mod, you're going really fast through the water and going to discover really many things. Also, right click made the light go on. Just for those who still new to this whole Subnautica thing. So, I'm going to cut out because I'm going to travel to my another base, so. Okay everybody, so now I made some few changes to my base, so I hope you like the view. So, what do you say? I just mounted this observatory into this place and I kinda put corridors around the Cyclop. Hopefully I can do more to do to this base, but for now I'm gonna leave it here. But thank you all so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and we will see you in the next video. So long.